a destructive volcanic monster is seemingly missing, and this could present a major problem. What I'm referring to is an unknown volcano which, in the year 426 BCE, produced what would become the single largest explosive volcanic eruption in the last 2,500 years. It was far larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, larger than the 1991 eruption of Mount Pinatubo, and even larger than the 1883 eruption of Krakatoa. Specifically, this eruption appears to have been 25% larger than the 1815 eruption of Tambora, which caused the year without a summer, meaning we are looking for a volcano which erupted around 160 cubic kilometers of tephra and has a young-looking large caldera. Yet, we have absolutely no clue which volcano created this eruption, nor where in the world the eruption occurred. All that we do know are its destructive after-effects, which triggered a famine in Athens, only to then subsequently exacerbate a severe disease outbreak in the same city. Both of these effects were caused by the more than 100 million tons of sulfur dioxide the ancient eruption produced, which combined with oxygen and water molecules in the atmosphere over the following few months to form sulfuric acid. This sulfuric acid then remained in the atmosphere for the following 3 years, deflecting large amounts of sunlight and causing worldwide temperatures and precipitation levels to drop in what is known as a volcanic winter. While the lower precipitation caused crops to fail, the decrease in sunlight striking the ground allowed a deadly disease outbreak to spread to a greater extent. In 426 BCE, the third wave of a likely typhoid fever outbreak struck, spreading through both contaminated food and water, but also through people leaving bacteria on various surfaces such as doors that they touched. Ordinarily, sunlight would kill any germs within a few minutes, but with reduced sunlight, the bacteria could remain for a longer period of time, increasing the average number of people an infected person would transmit the disease to. However, there is a possibility that the eruption which occurred was far smaller than might initially be expected. As, if magma at a volcano leached large amounts of sulfate from a layer rich in it, such as an evaporite deposit with abundant anhydrite, then a subsequent eruption might be unusually rich in sulfur dioxide gas. This is what occurred at Mexico's El Chichon volcano in 1982, which, if you were to have only looked at the sulfate spike it left in ice cores, might incorrectly assume the eruption was 4 times larger than it actually was. Thus, it is technically possible that a 40 cubic kilometer eruption generated the 426 BCE sulfate spike if its magma was unusually enriched in sulfur dioxide gas. Given the era when the eruption happened, it is most likely to have either occurred in the Americas, which did not have a strong written record at the time, the Ethiopia-Eritrea border area, or somewhere in Papua New Guinea, Tonga, or north of New Zealand's North Island. Looking further into the latter possibility, I have circumstantial evidence which seemingly supports an origin north of New Zealand's North Island. As, in the late 5th century BCE, an unusually powerful tsunami struck the North Island, which was completely uninhabited by humans at the time, striking areas up to 40 meters above sea level. While such a tsunami is more likely to have been generated by a megathrust earthquake, pyroclastic flows associated with a large volcanic island sinking into the ocean could have also been a cause. However, there is a single known large eruption which we do know occurred from a volcano whose margin of error gives it the possibility of being our 426 BCE mystery eruption. What I am referring to is Ecuador's Pululagua volcano, which produced at least a low NVEI-6 eruption that formed a voluminous caldera between 300 BCE and 600 BCE. Yet, Pululagua is far from being a good fit, so the source of the 426 BCE mystery eruption remains unresolved. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Donald Saunders for increasing their membership tier to this channel.